Hello, it's Vidas Pinkevičius, and today I'd like to show you how to create a processional march. And we'll use our My Sibelius program, and for that we'll start with the blank sheet, the blank score. We'll first add instruments. Let's agree that we need organ manuals only. This will be a piece without the pedals, so that you could easily play it on any keyboard instrument that you have, not necessarily with on organ with pedals. Okay, so here we go, and that's it. We need only to create perhaps the title of the piece. This will be Processional March in C. Okay, this will be its title. And let's create the subtitle too. Subtitle will be for organ without pedals. Okay. And the form of this piece is very simple, and this is one of the first things you need to think about: what kind of form you would like to be this piece, whether a ternary form or more complex form. Today I'd like to experiment with rondo form, which will have five parts, sort of three parts will be repeated. This will be called a refrain, and the parts and or episodes in the between these refrains will be called episodes. Okay, and so the form will be very simple. Let's write this on the screen for you. On the screen will be very simple. Yeah, perhaps here. A, B, A, C, A. Okay, this is, you can see in this example that three parts will be repeated. Okay, and the part one and part five will be in C, in the mode of C, and the middle A will be in the mode of G, in the dominant, basically. Okay, and then we'll compose or create B and C a little bit differently. These episodes will basically create a mild contrast with the main musical idea. Okay, so preliminaries are done. Now let's create a time signature. Time signature obviously needs to be 4-4. Okay, in all marches either 4-4 or 2-2. Common meter basically needs to be done. Okay, so this is the main thing. I'll expand a little bit so that you could see. So you could see the score a little better. Good. Maybe we'll need also the pickup. Okay, pickup sounds very nice, and pickup will be of the quarter note length. So this will be our pickup. Okay. And we're ready to proceed. The thing to create first is, of course, the theme. And the theme will be a short melody of four measures long in the mode of C, basically in white keys, white notes on the keyboard. We'll use interesting dotted rhythms because the processional marches have to have dotted rhythms. And we'll start with this G with the fifth scale degree. Okay, so So let's create something interesting right away. Maybe this way. Okay. And then this way. All right. And this way. This way. Well, a little bitter, a little more profound. So let's end on the fifth scale degree. So let's listen to what we have created. Okay, it could be this way, yeah. This is the very main idea of the piece. Okay. Let's copy this fragment, and of course let's put it in here too. And we'll need now to create basically another melody of four measures to complete this musical idea, because you see the fourth measure, this D note, is not incomplete, and we need to complete it. Okay, and we need to end on the first scale degree basically, but the ending is also a little bit different. This way, let's listen. Maybe to compensate this high A, we need also something interesting, something higher, F maybe, this way, and of course we need to have G here. Okay, this will be better. Okay, so this is our main theme. We could experiment more with this sixth measure also, because it's exact repetition of the second measure, right? And to make it more musical, maybe we'll change it a little bit. Maybe we could change it this way, high, a little bit higher. Okay, this is good enough, I think, for starters, and this is our first musical idea, complete musical idea. If the musical idea is ends on the different note than on the tonic note, not on the first scale degree, third scale degree, or the fifth scale degree, right? Then it's sort of a question. So this first note, first melody ending on the D was like a question, and we provided an answer. Answer was a little bit more complex, more artistically involved, advanced, but you could actually create an answer, direct answer, just ending on the tonic note. It would sound just fine. Okay. Now, we have the melody, but we don't have any harmony with it, okay? And we want to be able to play with our hands only, without the pedals. So for this to work is of course we need to have three lower voices, three lower parts. And in order to do this, I usually create first the bass, because the soprano, this is the soprano written in, and the bass is the foundation of harmony. Whenever I write in the bass first, then I know the exact harmony and I don't have to worry about it later on. Okay, and so can you. So you also can create the bass first, and then we'll fill in the two middle parts easily. All right, now this first G, of course, can be left without the harmony. It could be just the octave G to G. Usually pickups are simple octaves, but sometimes you can harmonize. If you want to harmonize, this could be a well dominant chord, G major chord on this note, on this pickup. But then later we'll do this tonic, okay? And whenever the melody goes up, we will try to go down with the bass to compensate. It will be an opposite motion, contrary motion with the soprano. Bass and soprano will go opposite direction most of the time. Sometimes it's not possible, so then we'll do something else. Okay, so C. Okay, and then we have to use the same chord, maybe C major six chord right here. C, A, G, C. Okay, and let's check the cadence. We need to have D. D in the soprano and G in the bass. G in the bass. Because this will be a dominant. And then this. Okay, so we have the parts of the bass line written in, and we'll fill in the blanks right here, right away. But first, let's look at the cadence. Cadence is very important. If we approach the cadence correctly, then the rest will fall into places. So this measure is the harmony before the cadence, and we want to be precise. F and A. Obviously this will be something from the subdominant side. Okay. Don't pay attention to these two G's, G and G. We'll fix that later on, but we worry about this A and F, okay? As well as F and D and C. Good. All right, the cadence is done. Now let's take a look at the notes before the cadence, preceding the cadence. Here we go. Subdominant sixth chord, tonic, and that's it. Here we need maybe second scale degree. Okay, maybe we could do something more advanced here. If we put this G here and G here, we will have dominant ninth chord. From G to A is a ninth. So we'll maybe do this. Okay, and then let's do the rest of this bass line. We finish with this. Maybe we'll need the dominant chord here, dominant sixth chord, tonic chord. Remember, we don't have to use direct chordal notes here, and perhaps we can use non-chordal notes right here. B is non-chordal accented note, and we can use in conjunction with this C. This is just one of the options, of course. Okay, and then here we need to have after this subdominant we need to have subdominant sixth chord and maybe again C downward, or this way. You see, it would be better to go downward with the bass from this measure to this measure, because the melody goes upward. Okay, so but we'll see if we can arrange this easily. Perhaps not so much. Except this way, we could do this way. This would compensate, of course. Okay, so let's check what we have created so far. Now, while looking at the score and listening to it right away, I would change this here, and I change this also a little bit also this note too. Let's hear it one more time. Maybe let's avoid avoid octaves, parallel octaves. G to C right here, and we have G to C right here. So maybe we'll use something different now. Tonic sixth chord would be better. And then maybe sixth scale degree chord right here. A little bit different harmony at the repetition. Okay, it's a little bit better now. I'm still not quite 100% satisfied with this excerpt, with this measure. So maybe we could also change a little bit this theme itself. The reason we cannot use the G here dominant, which would be obviously very easy, right? Is because here is the subdominant note, and the rule is in the classical tonal harmony is never to use the subdominant after the dominant, and that's why I'm hesitant to do this. By the way, let's listen to it this way. You see, it's a little bit out of place here, this G. But it would be better to do this. Let's listen. Maybe we'll leave it like that. And now let's create the two middle parts. For this to happen, we need to put the bass line as the second voice. Okay? The tenor will be our melody, G, right? We have G. And we'll also need to have the alto line. Let's prepare the alto here. Very good. Now okay. You see, whenever we write the alto part in this measure, the soprano stems are always up, and the alto part is always down, the bass is always downward, and the tenor will be up. Okay, let's fill in the chord, for example, of the tenor part, and here we have the first tonic chord, the first chord of our piece. Good. We'll continue, of course, creating this classical harmony chords in this excerpt, in this part A. Let's call it part A. Part A, because we'll need later on part B, and this will be different. So in this video, I'll teach you just the A part, and in the next video, we'll create part B, okay? Which will have a contrast with the A. Okay, so once we have this bass filled in, we can simply complete the chords very easily by looking at the bass. E signifies the tonic six chords, so we need this G, okay, this G in the alto, and of course C in the soprano. Don't worry about the repeated notes. Remember, repeated notes in the middle parts of the organ march don't always sound very well, or in the hymns also. So we need to do this way. Perhaps you see better, but I don't worry about this right now, because we'll later change this easily. I'll use the quarter notes. G, good. Okay. Tonic. Good. Subdominant six chord. Dominant. Tonic. Dominant six chord. This is tonic six chord. Subdominant six chord. Tonic. Subdominant six chord. Oops, let's fix this. And then we'll need B here. Dominant. This way. That was tonic six chord, tonic chord in this fifth measure, and then six scale degree chord. We will need something contrary with the bass, going upward. We'll check the doublings of the chord, if we need to double the root or the third. A is the root of this chord, third is the C. Maybe the C is better. Tonic six chord, subdominant chord, again subdominant, tonic, then tonic six chord, now this. Maybe we'll double the root on the second scale degree chord. Now inversion of the first inversion of the second scale degree chord. And dominant ninth chord and the tonic. Like this. Okay, we have our alto line. Let's check with the repeated notes. Let's put this here. Half note. We'll do quarter note here, because it's kind of going from one half of the measure to the another half of the measure, from the weaker beat to the stronger beat, and therefore we need to repeat this. Here we have the half note. Good. Again here. And here too. Good. And here too. This way too. Okay? And let's fill in the blanks with the tenor part. this way. The missing notes of the chord, basically. This way. Okay. This way. Good. Let's check our let's check the parallel fifths here. Bass and alto has parallel fifth, not necessarily parallel, but C F to C, right? And it resolves to the third G to B. That's okay. But our tenor line FF and GG with the bass needs to be fixed. Okay, this way. This way too. And maybe we could switch to another inversion. And here we'll make the bass line smoother too. Okay. So let's do this. And maybe this. Good. This way. Quarter note. G. An octave higher. Good. Good. Now we need this. And probably this. And this. Okay. Part B will continue from this pickup, and we'll fix that later. And before we wrap up this video, I'd like to check something in the tenor part. Here we need to have half notes. Half note, half note, half note, half note, you see, simplified. And this measure needs to be double checked for the harmony, especially how we approach this dominant ninth chord. I think it's okay. The main thing is to have the seventh of the chord going downward. Okay, this sort of passing ninth goes upward in stepwise motion to the third of the dominant seventh chord, and we are fine. So here we have now our completed section A. refrain. This will be a repeated episode from Processional March in C. Let's listen to it. Okay, in general it sounds, I think, convincing, but we have a problem, right? Remember, this is for organ without pedals, and the reach for the bass line between the two upper voices is always an octave or less. Here, even here, everywhere is an octave or less, so you can reach soprano and alto easily. But the reach between the bass and the tenor is sometimes larger. In tonal harmony, it's allowed. Four part harmony, it's allowed to have between the bass and the tenor an interval up to, I think, perfect 12. Basically, this is an octave plus a fifth, perfect fifth. It's allowed, but then you have to adjust a little bit the spacing for your hands, you see, if you play without the pedals. With pedals it would be just fine, right? We would play with the feet easily the bass line, but now we don't have the organ, right? Our task was to compose for the keyboard only. And we have to accommodate the changes. So, two options. There are two options here. Either in places where the reach is too high between the tenor and the bass, to play the tenor with the right hand, if possible. That's option one. Or to play the tenor with the bass in the left hand, but to do this a little bit differently, and to accommodate the bass line, making sure that the distance is not more than an octave. Okay, on older keyboards, on older 17th century organs, for example, or even 18th century organs, this would not be a problem in many cases, because you remember they had a short octave, incomplete short octave, and therefore the bass octave was incomplete and you could play wider intervals with your left hand much easier, up to a perfect 12. Yeah, and in general the keys were narrower, much narrower, so this is a problem on modern organs, of course, so we'll address this problem, and we'll double check now the reach between the bass and the tenor. Okay, and I think this is, although it's a tenth, is okay, because E could be played with the right hand, right? Now this C to A is not good, because we have to adjust it, maybe this way, yeah, likewise this, good. But then we will sometimes run into problems that all four parts go downward, one direction. So the bass needs to go upward, except we have to be careful that we avoid voice crossing. The bass should not go higher than the tenor, or the alto higher than the soprano, or the tenor higher than the alto, basically. Okay? Like with this. This is okay. Oh, this is fine. this is fine. Here we change this. Here we have to play this tenor with the right hand. Then it will be fine. Good. Now we have an interesting situation here. What to do with this G? Okay. If we put an octave higher, then remember the stepwise motion is a leap by the minor seventh. It doesn't sound nice. But if we do this, maybe we could do this easier. Okay. And this place is fine because the tenor can be played with the right hand. This goes upward. Good. Now this way I'm adjusting a little bit the bass line, the direction of the bass line. And this is fine because the D, the tenor, can be played with the right hand. Okay. I think we have to listen to what we have created so far, and it should sound more or less convincing now, unless we have another problem. Okay, obviously it sounds very nice. I think pretty solid for our processional march purposes. You can play it whenever you need such music. It's of course not incomplete composition, just the part A, but sounds solemn enough and joyful enough and optimistic. Except we have. I'm still not positive about this triangle in the bass. F, B, A. And for this we may have to reinvent something. And maybe the solution would be more complex in this way. Let's listen to it one more time and decide whether we need to change it or not. I think from the second run, I think the air didn't pick up this as a bad thing, as a bad interval, this major minor seventh leap upward. So I think we have created our section A refrain correctly, more or less, and we can leave it like that. And in the next video I will show you how to create part B episode of this. Okay, contrasting theme will be a little bit different. Maybe we'll play on the different manual. And of course, When you do this, remember we need to have in mind that in this music we will use lots of legato and finger substitutions, right? Because we have to play legato in this kind of music, because the style is not Baroque, it's not early music, it's more or less like 19th century hymns, marches, and for this we use legato style and perhaps lots of finger substitutions, which allow us to play legato and sometimes even finger glissandos if you need. Okay, I don't think we need in this excerpt, but we may need it later on. Okay, so thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you again next time with part B.